dog to match his suit. That's not a dog, that's a raccoon.
Shelly, you okay? My mom called and told me you were being picketed by a bunch of circus clowns.
Why'd you come in the back?
Oh, I didn't want to cross the picket line. I'm a union man, you know.
Remember when Shelly got on her high horse and said we couldn't design for that pimp? Well, this mess is the result. It's been like this all day. Not one customer has come in. Yeah, and we've been getting threatening phone calls from girls named Tasmania and Alizé. Uh-uh. I know they are not setting up a barbecue grill out there. Oh, damn, they got hot links. Look, he's coming. He's coming in.
I'm here to parlay.
All right, let me handle this. Come on, man. You made your point, all right? Now just leave the ladies alone.
Excuse me, do I know you?
I don't think so.
Then why are you talking to me?
Look, man. The ladies don't want to do business with you because they're offended by what you do for a living.
So? Everybody's job offends somebody. What do you do?
Well, not that it's any of your business, but, I'm a licensed physical therapist.
A nurse man. Fool, talk to me when you become a doctor.
You see, talking is just how it starts. And how it ends is up to you.
Are you threatening me? Excuse me. We have a situation. Code blue. Now, what are you saying, nurse man?
Are these supposed to be your bodyguards? Because I could take the little one.
Bodyguards, man, these are my attorneys, Comfort and Sugar Free.
Fully certified in 3 states and a little bit certified in 2.
And pursuant to a satisfactory resolution of this dispute, parties of the first part hereby known as Party Over Here.
Hey!
Pursue his grievance against the party over there.
How? I'm sorry, I got caught up.
So until our client gets his suit, we'll be here every day.
Oh, you people can march up and down the street until you wear the heels off your Stacey Adams. We're standing strong.
And when you finish making my suit, throw in a pair of gaiters for the nurse man. Because them hush puppies he's wearing don't go with nothing.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
See, I tried to turn the other cheek. And
I'm sorry you had to work late last night. What time did you get off?
I don't know. I wasn't wearing my watch.
Were you wearing anybody?
What?
Hey, guys. Everything all right?
Yeah, everything's cool.
Nick, do you have the time?
Sure, Donovan. Let me check. My watch. It's gone.
Did you forget to put it on?
Oh, please. I think we both know what happened to my watch.
You think I took it?
So you admit it.
Have you lost your mind? I didn't steal your watch, Nick.
So, everything's okay then. Great.
You know, I think this has just been one big misunderstanding. So I tell you what. I'm gonna close my eyes. You slide my watch over. We'll act like this never happened.
Do come again, drive safe.
You know, I'm starting to think she didn't steal my watch.
Last picketer just pulled off in a periwinkle Mercedes with Burberry interior.
Pimp or no pimp, that's a hot-ass car.
You think they'll be back tomorrow?
I hope not. We're losing a lot of business to that picket line. Maybe we should just cave and make Rodney suit.
No, maybe you shouldn't. Look, I like the way you're sticking to your guns, not doing something just to make a quick buck.
You usually call it stubborn.
Well, it's only stubborn when you do it to me. You know, I don't want to scare you, but you say the word, and I'll call some people to handle this.
Oh, no, JT, I don't want to take it there.
Good, because the only people I can call are Nick and Donovan.
Look, the girls and I are having a meeting tonight. This is our problem, and we're going to handle it. Thanks, though.
All right, well, call me if you need me.
Okay.
Shelley, where'd you get this watch?
Oh, it's yours. I'm sorry. I forgot to tell you I borrowed it. Looks good, though, huh?
It's not my watch. It's Nick's.
Oh, well, tell him I said thanks.
Okay. He'll probably have a few things to tell you, too.
Hey, Nick, Donna. Got a funny story for you.
Okay, see, Shelley, she says hi, by the way. Anyway, Shelley borrowed what she thought was my watch. And guess what? It's not my watch. It's yours.
That is a great story, JT.
I think so.
Why are you laughing? My girl's pissed at me because I called her a thief. And the whole time, your girl's the klepto.
Come on, Nick, be a man. Just call her up. Bravo. Buy something nice. Like a watch.
Danny, hey, what's up? Guess what? Baby, no, look. Oh, see, now you don't even know my mom.
So, how we doing back there, Rodney?
Y'all got to be kidding me.
Oh, you look like Al Roker.
Watch your mouth.
Well, I think he looks great. Very classy.
Is this what you ordered?
Hell no.
Excuse me. Yes, it is. Blue suit, double-breasted, 34 waist, 42 regular jacket.
What about the shiny fabric that I picked out?
Check out the lining.
Well, what happened to my crushed velvet pockets?
Put your hands inside.
Why the hell would I want crushed velvet on the inside?
You know, we asked ourselves the same question, but decided, hey, the customer's always right.
Look, Rodney, when you hire Diva Style, you hire artists who have a unique vision for every design.
Frankly, I'm offended that you would question our creative instinct. And if you don't like our work, feel free to take your business elsewhere.
Comfort, sugar-free, draw up a motion. We're going to court.
I don't think so, Rodney. Technically, they have fulfilled their fiduciary obligations.
Then technically, you're fired.
Fine. Then the firm of Comfort, Sugar Free, and Goldberg no longer represents your pimping ass.
This is not what I ordered, and I want my money back.
Fine. We want our suit back.
Fine. I hope you know you will be blacklisted by the NPA.
Who?
National Players Association. Our motto, we do pimping right.
Well, I guess we'll just have to struggle along without you.
Look, I knew I was in favor of keeping the money, but I'm glad we stuck to our principles and thought our way through this.
And I just want to say, I am so proud to be associated with such savvy, responsible business women.
Me too. Let's close up early and go get drunk.
Good idea.
I can't believe you accused me of stealing.
I don't blame you for being mad. But you gotta remember, I work for the IRS. I think everybody's stealing.
But you really hurt my feelings, Nick.
I know. It was stupid. And I promise, I'll do something even more stupid down the road.
You're lucky you're cute.
Girl, stop. I prefer hands.
Check out Huggy Bear by the door.
Oh, my God.
What?
That's my Uncle Jerry.
Shelly, huh? Baby girl.
Hey, Uncle Jerry. Hi, Aunt Honeybee, Cousin Precious.
How you doing? I'm JT, Shelly's boyfriend. You know, I've heard a lot about you.
So have the cops. But they can't prove nothing.
So what brings you to town?
But the Players Ball. They're giving me the Lifetime Achievement Award.
And your mama said I wouldn't amount to nothing.
You show her.
Precious, get out your camera. We're gonna take a family picture.
Well, you know what? Let me take it. I'm moving close. Smile, Shelly. One, two, three, Shelly.
Hell.
You know, I'm starting to think she didn't steal my wife.
Last picket had just pulled off in a periwinkle Mercedes with Burberry interior.
Pimp or no pimp, that's a hot-ass car.
You think they'll be back tomorrow?
I hope not. We're losing a lot of business to that picket line. Maybe we should just cave and make Rodney sue.
No, maybe you shouldn't. Look, I like the way you're sticking to your guns, not doing something just to make a quick buck.
You usually call it stubborn.
Well, it's only stubborn when you do it to me. You know, I don't want to scare you, but you say the word, and I'll call some people to handle this.
Oh, no, JT, I don't want to take it there.
Good, because the only people I can call are Nick and Donovan.
Look, the girls and I are having a meeting tonight. This is our problem, and we're going to handle it. Thanks, though.
All right, well, call me if you need me.
Okay.
Whoa. Shelly, where'd you get this watch?
Oh, it's yours. I'm sorry. I forgot to tell you I borrowed it. Looks good, though, huh?
It's not my watch. It's Nick's.
Oh, well, tell him I said thanks.
Okay. He'll probably have a few things to tell you, too. Hey, Nick, Donovan. Got a funny story for you.
Yeah?
Okay, see, Shelly, she says hi, by the way. Anyway, Shelly borrowed what she thought was my watch, and guess what? It's not my watch. It's yours.
That is a great story, JT.
I think so.
Why you laugh? My girl's pissed at me because I called her a thief, and the whole time your girl's the klepto.
Come on, Nick, be a man. Just cool her up. Bravo. Buy something nice. Like a watch.
Danny, hey, what's guess what? Baby, no, look. Oh, see, now you don't even know my mom.
So, how we doing back there, Rodney?
Y'all got to be kidding me.
Oh, you look like Al Roker.
Watch your mouth.
Well, I think he looks great. Very classy.
Is this what you ordered?
Hell no.
Excuse me, yes it is. Blue suit, double-breasted, 34 waist, 42 regular jacket.
What about the shiny fabric that I picked out?
Check out the lining.
Now, what are you saying, nurse man?
Supposed to be your bodyguards, because I could take the little one.
Bodyguards, man, these are my attorneys. Comfort and sugar-free.
Fully certified in 3 states and a little bit certified in 2.
And pursuant to a satisfactory resolution of this dispute, parties of the first part hereby known as party over here.
Hey!
Pursue his grievance against the party over there.
Until our clients gets his suit, we'll be here every day.
Oh, you people can march up and down the street until you wear the heels off your Stacey Adams. We're standing strong.
Oh, and when you finish making my suit, throw in a pair of gaiters for the nurse man. Because them hush puppies he's wearing don't go with nothing.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
I'm sorry you had to work late last night. What time did you get off?
I don't know. I wasn't wearing my watch.
Were you wearing anybody?
What?
Hey, guys. Everything all right?
Yeah, everything's cool.
Nick, do you have the time?
Sure, Donovan, let me check.
My watch. It's gone.
Did you forget to put it on?
Oh, please. I think we both know what happened to my watch.
You think I took it?
So you admit.
Have you lost your mind? I didn't steal your watch, Nick.
So, everything's okay then. Great.
You know, I think this has just been one big misunderstanding. So I tell you what. I'm gonna close my eyes. You slide my watch over. We'll act like this never happened.
Do come again. Drive safe.
You know, I'm starting to think she didn't steal my watch.
Last picket had just pulled off in a periwinkle Mercedes with Burberry interior.
Pimp or no pimp, that's a hot-ass car.
You think they'll be back tomorrow?
I hope not. We're losing a lot of business to that picket line. Maybe we should just cave and make Rodney sue.
No, baby, you shouldn't. Look, I like the way you're sticking to your guns, not doing something just to make a quick buck.
You usually call it stubborn.
Last picket had just pulled off in a periwinkle Mercedes with Burberry interior.
Pimp or no pimp, that's a hot-ass car.
You think they'll be back tomorrow?
I hope not. We're losing a lot of business to that picket line. Maybe we should just cave and make Rodney sue.
No, baby, you shouldn't. Look, I like the way you're sticking to your guns, not doing something just to make a quick buck.
You usually call it stubborn.
Well, it's only stubborn when you do it to me. You know, I don't want to scare you, but you say the word, and I'll call some people to handle this.
Oh, no, JT, I don't want to take it there.
Good, because the only people I can call are Nick and Donovan.
Look, the girls and I are having a meeting tonight. This is our problem, and we're going to handle it. Thanks, though.
All right, well, call me if you need me.
Okay.
Whoa. Shelley, where'd you get this watch?
Oh, it's yours. I'm sorry. I forgot to tell you I borrowed it. Looks good, though, huh?
It's not my watch. It's Nick's.
Oh, well, tell him I said thanks.
Okay. He'll probably have a few things to tell you, too. Hey, Nick, Donovan. Got a funny story for you. Okay, see, Shelly, she says hi, by the way. Anyway, Shelly borrowed what she thought was my watch. And guess what? It's not my watch. It's yours.
That is a great story, JT.
I think so.
Why are you laughing? My girl's pissed at me because I called her a thief. And the whole time, your girl's the klepto.
Come on, Nick, be a man. Just cool her off. Bravo. Buy something nice. Like a watch.
Danny, hey, what's guess what?
Baby,
no, look. Oh, see, now you don't even know my mom.
So, how we doing back there, Rodney?
Y'all got to be kidding me.
Oh, you look like Al Roker.
Watch your mouth.
Well, I think he looks great. Very classy.
Is this what you ordered?
Hell no.
Excuse me. Yes, it is. Blue suit, double-breasted, 34 waist, 42 regular jacket.
What about the shiny fabric that I picked out?
Check out the lining.
Well, what happened to my crushed velvet pockets?
Put your hands inside.
What the hell would I want crushed?